Ladies and gentlemen, we have been using WhatsApp for most of our lives, right? And it is a must-have app for everyone. So why not learn some useful tricks that can make our experience much better on the platform? Sounds interesting? Then let's dive in, shall we? Alright, let's begin with a feature that's only available on iPhones. And you guessed it right, it's long press. When long pressed, you can easily start a new chat or look for a specific chat, or the best part, open the camera, click a photo and send it to multiple contacts without having to go to the native camera app first and then share it through WhatsApp. My QR code option is left here that will be covered later in this video, so stay tuned. Talking about long press, if you want to read someone's chat without letting them know, just long press on a chat and you should be able to read the latest messages without giving intimation to the sender. But the sender can still make out that you're online. So what if you want to read the message without worrying about being online? Simply head to settings at the bottom, then privacy and change last seen to nobody if you have not already done that. And then change who can see I am online to same as last seen, that means nobody. And finally disable read receipts. And as we are already here, a quick tip. Not everyone knows that we can enable Face ID for WhatsApp on an iPhone. It is done from here. Got it? So back to our trick. You have now officially become a ghost. You can read someone's messages without leaving a single hint of that to the sender. Like this trick? Then don't forget to smash that like button. Moving on to another privacy feature. Do you dislike someone looking in your phone when you are maybe sitting beside them, or your phone is kept on the table while in a meeting and messages keep popping up? Well, to solve this, we'll head to our system settings and scroll down till we find WhatsApp. Then notifications and show previews. Set previews to never. So now, even if you receive a text when your phone is unlocked, there will be a pop-up, but it still won't display the previews. But there's always another but. It'll still display a preview when I am using the app, I mean WhatsApp. So if you want to take it one more step further, head to settings, then notifications and in-app notifications here, and tap on none here. Let the sound and vibrate be on. So this way, whenever you are using WhatsApp, you receive a message, the phone will vibrate, it will even give a sound if the phone is not on silent, but it will not show the preview. And just like that, you will be 100% shielded from evil eyes. There are times when even after reading the chat, we want to refer to that chat later on, maybe for work or a reminder. So a simple trick is to long press the chat and mark it as unread. This will immediately show a dot to make that chat stand out. But adding on to this, if you have lots of chats like these, you can even make it quicker and tap on this small triangle here. This will filter out all the unread messages for you to make it much more convenient. Now, what if you don't want to come back to the chat but need to grab a specific item on a daily basis? Maybe a photo or a location or a text from the chat. Well, what I do is long tap on anything like that, for example my office location, and start it. Now when I need it again, I'll switch to my settings and open my start messages option. Select my item and share. Trust me, this will make your workflow much more faster than usual. Do you find groups annoying? I mean, I'm added into many groups and some of them are super active. Like, it is very distracting to be receiving so many messages in a day. So I ended up putting all the groups to archive. Slide the chat to your left and push it to archive. Now for this to work as intended, head to settings, chats this time, and enable keep chats archived. Now this way, whenever you receive messages on those groups, there will be no notification, your chat's homepage will be clean, and you can check the messages at your free time from the archive folder. Let me know in the comments, would you use this? Next is QR code. Instead of sending someone your contact number, just share your personal QR code or ask them to scan it right away. Your QR code will be next to your name in settings. Now, if you were wondering how do we start a chat with a QR code, it's very simple. Tap on new chat icon here and then new contact, and our magic QR code option is here. Tap on that and either scan or select it from your photos, and your chat will start right away. To be honest, QR code is kinda cool, but we have a brand new feature to begin chats on WhatsApp. Tap on the new chat icon again, and now you can choose yourself to chat with. Just type in the number and send. Tap on the number and start chatting right away. You can even use this chat as a to-do list for yourself. WhatsApp has one more brand new feature. You can now share a poll to a group or even a single contact. Type in your question and answers for the poll and send. Now when someone chooses an option, or two to three options for that matter, it'll display here with the count, and when you view the votes, it will give you a perfect result at the end. Final tip, my gallery gets filled up with unnecessary photos that eventually I end up deleting later. So why not use this feature under chats tab in settings and disable save to camera role. Now, whenever you receive a photo or video, you can choose which ones are worthy to be in your gallery and save it. And once every month, either delete that chat filled with media, or if that chat is actually important to you, tap on the contact, then media, select all the photos together and delete. This way, your iCloud data will be saved from clotting, and only photos you choose will end up in your gallery. A bonus tip to make my video 8 minutes long for that one extra advertisement. To call multiple people together on WhatsApp, it is not necessary for all of the participants to be added in a group, although it's much easier to call this way, but not always convenient. So head to Calls tab, tap on the call icon here, and choose the group call option here. Now select up to 7 people you want to call together and choose between video and voice call, and you should be good to go. Now if you want to schedule a call instead, just tap on create a call link here, choose between video and voice call again, and share it with the timing to as many as 7 people at a time. And that's all. For more videos, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching. My name is Mufaddal. This is Apple Vibes. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.